Hi there. You know, we all go through times where we're lacking motivation for photography. Maybe things just aren't working out for you. You're not finding the subjects that you want. You're not finding it interesting anymore. And there's a lot of advice out there about what to do in those circumstances. And almost all of it says, take a break. And I think that's the very worst thing that you can do. So I'm going to share with you today what I do to recharge my batteries for photography. And that's both metaphorically speaking and literally, because the good folks at SmallRig have sent me their USB rechargeable batteries to try. So come with me today whilst I talk about both those things, and I'm going to aim to photograph some kingfishers. So for me, one of the best ways to get my motivation back is to revisit a species I've photographed in the past. It's like revisiting an old friend, but to find a new way to photograph them. So today, I've come to a nature reserve where I know I'm pretty much guaranteed to be able to photograph a kingfisher. And it's not a nature reserve I come to often because the pond is quite a distance away from the hides. And so I've got my doubler on, my 2x teleconverter, otherwise I'm going to get nowhere near those birds. But if I can find a new and interesting way to photograph those birds, it might get me interested again. But it's much better to do that than taking a break from photography. With anything you do in life, if you're trying to change a habit and then you go back to old habits, it's even harder to get into your future desired behaviour that you want to get to. So whether that is dieting or exercising or doing more sport, whatever it is, if you take a break from that, it's even harder to go back to it again. So I say, keep moving forward, but find a way to keep it interesting. So let's get the safety shots in the bag first, and then I'll tell you about what I'm going to try and do. So let's talk about these SmallRig batteries. So I'm not much of a person who likes to use third-party batteries for a variety of reasons, but these ones really intrigued me. So they are a USB chargeable battery. So most batteries for cameras, you have to plug into an adapter unit and charge from the mains. These, under this little cover, have got a USB socket just here at the back that allows you to plug it into a USB cable. So you can charge it from a USB socket, you can charge it from the 12 volt in your car, you can charge it directly from your computer, you can charge it from a power bank. So it creates a lot of convenience. And the price is quite low. So for the Sony version, these are £45 compared to Sony's recommended retail price of £75 per battery. So they're significantly cheaper. They also do a version for Canon and one for Fuji. And I'll put the number of those batteries on the screen, but they are the main batteries that work in a lot of Sony, Canon and Fuji cameras. Now, with the 5 volt, 2.5 amp cable that comes with the battery, you can charge it from flat to fully charged in 2.5 hours, whereas my Sony version of that battery takes 3 hours. So not only is it cheaper, but it charges faster. But are they as good? I've been using them for the last couple of weeks, and I'm using them all today, and I will tell you my thoughts at the end of this. So now I've got those safety shots in the bag, I want to create something a bit more abstract, and I'm going to use a technique called ICM, which is different from the way I photographed kingfishers in the past. And what this is, you use a slightly longer shutter speed and move the camera ever so slightly just to create some blur in the picture and hopefully create something that looks like a post-impressionistic painting. So I'm going to use shutter speed of between, say, half a second and a second. I've got my remote release shutter on so that I can press the shutter with this hand and move the camera with this one. And because I've got that shutter speed of between half a second and a second, I've needed to put my ND filter on. So I've got one of my Freewell ND32 filters on the end there. If you want to know about those filters, you can go and watch another video that I've made that I'll link above and in the description below. But what I'm going to do, when a kingfisher comes and lands on that or any of the perches, I'll start the exposure using the remote release shutter and then just move the camera ever so slightly. Doesn't take much, just a little wobble, and that will introduce the movement that will create the effect I'm looking for. So it does help to have your camera on something stable. I'm using my platy pod plus my gimbal head, and that's going to keep the camera locked down, but I've still just got a little bit of play in it, a little bit of movement. I can do that. So let's take a test shot now. So if I press the shutter with the remote release and just gently wiggle the camera with my other hand, you'll see the effect I'm going for. So here we go. So let's have a look at those. So there you can see we've got some interesting motion in that picture. And if I manage to do that when a kingfisher lands on one of those perches, it should create a really nice effect. In between waiting for the kingfishers, this wood pigeon turned up, so I took a shot of it. And I have to say, I think it might be my favourite abstract of the day. It just looks so angry. So, a little bit more on these small rig batteries. Now, I mentioned earlier that I'm not a big fan of using third-party batteries, and one of the reasons for that is that when you put them in your camera, you get a warning message about compatibility. That often makes you worry that you might be damaging your camera, things like that. And the reason you get those warning messages is because batteries, or the good ones, have decoder chips built into them so that your camera knows the difference between an individual battery. So I've got mine numbered 4 and 5. I've put on them just so I know the difference, but the camera doesn't need those numbers 4 and 5. It knows the serial number of those batteries because they've got a decoder chip built into them. Now, these small rig ones have a decoder chip built into them, so they work just like the native batteries, and your camera can tell the difference between them. And why is that important? So I've got two batteries here in the battery grip extension, and the camera knows the difference between those batteries. So as one runs down, it knows to move on to the other. But if I replace the one that's run down with a third battery, it will know to carry on using the second battery before it moves to the third one. So it always uses the charge sequentially. And I know in other brands, Canon, for example, you can tell about the health of that battery in your camera. So Canon will tell you if it's running out of life effectively, if it's not charging and discharging as efficiently as it used to. You can get that information from your camera. Now, that we don't have in Sony, but you only get that in Canon with those batteries that have got decoder chips built in. So that's really important. Now, I've been using these batteries for a couple of weeks now, and I have noticed that they last longer than the Sony ones. And I initially thought about doing a little test and running them down side by side, perhaps filming some video, something like that, to see which ones run out first. But that wouldn't really be fair because all my Sony batteries are a couple of years old. And so you would ideally want to run two brand new batteries side by side to carry out that test. But it does appear to me that these last longer. And when you look at the stats, the published specification for the battery, the milliamp hours is higher. Let me just check the numbers. So it's 2400 milliamp hours for this battery, and it's 2280 for Sony. So that means these have a bit more charge in them, effectively. These can last a little bit longer. So that is a really good thing. So overall, they're cheaper, they are more convenient to charge, they last longer, and they work just as well, if not better, than the native ones. So why wouldn't you buy them? It's a fantastic deal. So the next ICM technique I want to talk about is using the rings on your lens. So you can use the zoom ring if you've got a zoom lens, or you can use the manual focusing ring on any lens. So let's start with the zoom technique. So what you want to do is focus on the bird. In this case, for the test shot, we'll focus on the wood that the bird is going to land on, hopefully, and be as zoomed out as possible, or fairly well zoomed out. And then as you take the exposure for a fraction of a second, maybe half a second to a second, something like that, you move the zoom ring and zoom in. So hopefully you can see on here, as I'm zooming in, I'm going to take the exposure, and that will give you an effect that looks like you're kind of going down a tunnel. It's a kind of tunnel vision type effect, like you're getting sucked in towards the bird. The second technique is using the manual focusing ring. And what you want to do is hold the focusing ring and turn the camera. And what will happen there is it will create an effect that looks like the outside is moving around the bird. So as you're pressing the shutter, you're holding the manual focusing ring and turning the camera. And that is what's going to give you that swirling effect. So I feel thoroughly refreshed after spending a bit of time doing something different. And it doesn't have to be ICM. You just need to find something different from what you normally do. So a different way to photograph a species that you've photographed a lot in the past, or even going to a new location. Just find something different to give you that little bit of inspiration that you might need. And coming back to the batteries, that has been really useful for me to see these batteries in action over the period of a couple of weeks now, and I'm super impressed with them. When I do product reviews, I give you my total unbiased review, and any of you who have seen my product reviews in the past, I'll always give you what I think are the negative points as well as the positives. But I can't see any negatives with these. They're cheaper, they work just as well, they're more convenient. Why would you not get them? So if you have one of those types of batteries for Sony, Canon or Fuji, next time you need a new battery, you might as well go and buy the small rig version. So I hope that has been useful for you. And if you are interested to learn a little bit more about the filters that I've used to enable me to get those ICM shots, you might like to check out this video. Thanks very much for watching, and I'll see you next time.